Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to talk about a very important topic in biochemistry, that is actually your Ramachandran plot analysis. You know, it is very important for this year's life sciences exam point of view, and also very important for your concept building if you are a biochemistry student. So before diving into this topic, I will suggest you, if you are yet to watch my last video regarding your dihedral angle or a torsional angle, please watch that video first, then come back and watch this video. I will provide the links of that video in my I button and also in the description.
Let's get started, friends.
Before diving into the topic Ramachandran plot analysis, we must have some knowledge about your what exactly peptide is, what exactly is your peptide bond, and what exactly are your dihedral or torsional angles, and how exactly they can, you know, determine the how a particular polypeptide chain can take a particular secondary structure, right? So for your convenience, I have already drawn a dipeptide here. This is a dipeptide, and from this to this is one amino acid. This is one bit dipeptide, means there are two amino acids joined together by peptide bond. Okay, this is an amino acid. This is an amino acid. They are joined by this is your peptide bond. Okay, they're joined by peptide bond. As we know that peptide bond is non peptide bond is rigid, it cannot rotate, right? But the bond surrounding the peptide bond, like your C alpha C bond and your N C alpha bond, they can rotate. When C alpha C bond rotates by forming an angle, this angle is called the psi angle. And when C alpha and N bond rotates, it can form an angle is called as phi angle, right? So in the last lecture, we have already discussed that these two angles, like your phi angle, psi angle, or we can say your dihedral angles, can affect the the polypeptide chain to take a particular conformation, secondary conformation. That means the value of phi and psi, sorry, the value of psi and phi will determine what type of secondary bond, sorry, secondary structure a particular polypeptide chain amino acid is going to take, right? So we have here mentioned that the dihedral angle between your C alpha C is called as psi angle, and your dihedral angle between that is formed by the rotation of C alpha and N is called as phi angle, right? So let's talk about your Ramachandran plot analysis actually. So actually Ramachandran plot analysis, that means it was put forwarded by an Indian scientist. His name was actually Gopala Samudran Narayanan Ramachandran, right? Popularly we call him as G.N. Ramachandran. He actually proposed this concept, and the mechanism of his concept was that how exactly your dihedral angle or torsional angle, or we can say phi value and psi value, could determine what type of secondary structure a particular polypeptide is going to be depending on the values of phi and psi, right? Okay, and he actually studied about your different secondary structure amino acids, like your alpha helix, beta seeds, and collagens. He actually studied individual amino acids or participating amino acids that were actually participating in the formation of peptide bond, and finally they were forming your polypeptide, right? So he was determining the values of your phi and psi for each and every participant amino acid, and then he showed how exactly these values, the phi and psi values of different polypeptide chain, were the driving factors that actually make a particular polypeptide chain to take a particular secondary conformation. Okay, so this was actually the theme of his study, and Actually, one thing you must remember that as we know that phi and phi, the value of phi and the value of psi could be anything ranging between minus 180 degree to your plus 180 degree. But actually, this was not the case. He actually considered the fact that actually your steric hindrance, actually, this is a force that was actually created by the presence of your R group or side chain group of your amino acid, individual amino acid. The larger was your steric hindrance force, right? So the actual function of this the utility of your Ramachandran plot analysis was actually Ramachandran plot analysis has a great value in determining the particular structure, this particular secondary structure a particular polypeptide chain is going to have if we have data on the values of phi and psi, right? So actually Ramachandran determined the individual phi and psi values of different individual amino acids present in a particular polypeptide chain. He also actually, as we know that the values of phi and psi could be any value between ranging between your minus 180 degree to your plus 180 degree. And he also, taken into account, he also considered the fact that steric hindrance could limit the rotation freedom of these types of bonds, the C alpha C bonds and N C alpha bonds, right? And actually, after considering the effect of your steric hindrance caused by these side groups, side chains of amino acids, and then he actually tabulated different values like your phi value and psi values of individual amino acids of a particular secondary structure. Like he studied differently, like your he studied for alpha helix, different amino acids in alpha helix, beta helix and all, right? Then he actually did what? He actually put the value of phi and psi in a graphical method to show exactly, this plot or this graph could be divided into your four blocks or your four quadrant, you can say. And about this we will discuss in next 3-4 minutes, right? So actually he put them, he put these values in a graphical form, and he became successful to show the regions in the quadrant that were actually allowed regions, we can say, where actually the value of phi and psi could lie, right? And he also showed the regions where actually no phi and psi value can be formed. That means the regions where actually no such type of rotation can be formed by taking the values from that region, right? So in the next part of the videos, let's see how exactly he devised this process. And please stay tuned. Let's discuss Ramachandran plot in much more detail, right? So as I have already told that before plotting this graph, Ramachandran had already measured different phi and psi values of individual amino acids present in a particular type of secondary structure, okay? So first of all, Ramachandran did, he actually measured the individual values of phi and psi angles of different amino acids of different types of polypeptides and leading to form different types of your secondary structures like your alpha helix, beta sheet, right? Like this, right? So first of all, he measured different phi and psi values of different amino acids for a particular polypeptide chain to become antiparallel beta sheet, it must have your phi value like minus 139 degree and your psi value like 135 degree. For a particular amino acid chain to become parallel beta sheet, it must have a phi value like minus 119 degree and a psi value like 115 degree. for a particular like this for a particular polypeptide chain to become or to adopt a secondary structure of right handed alpha helix, it must have phi value like minus 57 degree and a psi value like minus 47 degree. Like this for your left handed alpha helix, the phi value should be plus 57 degree and a psi value should be plus 47 degree. For collagen, the phi value should be plus minus 51 degree, yes, I value should be plus 153 degree, right? This so after tabulating all these values or all the value of phi and psi for different amino acids present in a particular polypeptide chain, he did what? He actually, you know, he actually plotted a graph. Okay, he plotted a graph. This is called a Ramachandran plot, or it can be also called a Ramachandran graph actually. So he did what? He actually plotted a graph taking your the value of phi in degree in your x-axis. He took the value the value of psi in your y-axis, right? Both phi and psi are taken in degree. So you know, you can see that as we know that the value of phi and psi should be any value ranging from 0 minus 180 degree to plus 180. You can see that we have plotted the value minus 180 degree here, from one minus 180 degree to 0 and plus 180 degree for your in x-axis for phi value. In for psi, we have taken the value like minus 180 degree, 0 and plus 180 degree. It also ranging, it is also ranging from minus 180 to plus 180. So then he actually did what? He actually, you know, he had already, I have already told that he already, he had, you know, tabulated all the values, and then he exactly plotted the individual degree, plotted the graph. The graph, in the graph, he actually plotted these values, phi and psi values. So for individual amino acid, like your, for antiparallel beta acid, he has your, he has plotted your, phi value or psi value, and by plotting the phi and psi values of different polypeptide chains, he actually was able to form a graph like structure. This is called a Ramachandran plot, which actually shows us different regions. The red regions, like these are red regions and these are white regions. The red regions are, we can say, are actually your allowed region, are actually your allowed region, where actually, you know, the rotation is possible. Actually, the phi and psi value can take your this value, their values from this region. If they take their values from this region, they're gonna become your particular type of secondary structure, like your alpha helix or beta, like this. If they are going to take the values, some values from here, from this disallowed region, that means from white regions, they are never going to form such type of stable secondary structures. Okay, that means in the white region, in these white regions, or you can say in this disallowed region, actually, there is steric hindrance forces. Actually, due to steric hindrance forces, which is actually generally created by the presence of your side group or your side chain, the larger the side group is, the more will be your steric hindrance actually. So in these regions, actually, there will be steric hindrances. So if your phi and psi value, psi angles are going to take values from these disallowed regions, from these white regions, they are never going to, make a particular stable secondary structure, because they are going to experience the force of steric hindrances. But these red colored regions are your stable regions, are actually your allowed regions. In these regions, actually, there will be no such hindrances. They are going to take, if they are going to take the values from this red or your red colored region or your allowed region, they are certainly going to form a secondary structure like alpha helix, beta helix, beta your alpha helix, beta sheet, like this. So we can see that in the first quadrant there are four quadrants over here. So in the first quadrant we can see there are if the polypeptide chain is going to take the phi and psi values from these regions, they are going to certainly form your anti-parallel beta sheet, parallel beta sheet, and your collagen helix. If the polypeptide chain having your phi and psi angle value taking from this region, they are going certain to become your left handed alpha helix. If a particular amino acid chain or polypeptide chain is going to take the values from this region, they are certainly going to be your right handed alpha helix. So this is what exactly your Ramachandran plot looks like. For your convenience, I am going to draw it. I'm just going to plot it once again for your better understanding, right? So you can see not to spend more time, I have already drawn this. As I have told that in x-axis I have taken the value of 5, in y-axis I have taken the value of psi. Both the values are in degree, so the values are ranging from minus, both for phi and psi, the values are ranging from minus 180 plus 180 minus 180 plus 180 degree. So let's see how exactly we are drawing this or plotting this graph. For empty parallelepiped acid, we know that the phi value should be minus 139 degree and phi value should be plus 135 degree. So first of all, we should, phi value should be your minus 139 degree, that means somewhere here, and your psi value should be your minus 115 plus 115 degree, that means somewhere here. That means it is going to be formed somewhere here, right? It is going to be formed somewhere here. Okay, so for your parallel beta set, your phi value should be like your minus 119 degree. Phi value should be your minus 119 degree, and your psi value should be like your plus 115 degree. That means somewhere here. So this is your. Okay. So actually I have committed a mistake. This is okay, there is no problem. For parallel beta set, the phi value should be your minus 119, that means phi value should be your minus 119 somewhere here, no problem. And your psi value should be like your plus 115. That means your parallel beta sheet is going to be present somewhere here. This is your parallel beta, okay, this region. And antiparallel beta sheet, your phi value should be your like your minus 139 degree. That means somewhere here. And your the psi value should be your plus 135 means not here, actually here in this region. Okay, so this is your anti-parallel beta sheet, this is your parallel beta sheet. Okay, for collagen we know that your phi value should be your minus 51 degree phi value. That means somewhere here, minus 51. And your psi value should be like your plus 153. That means plus phi value should be minus 51 somewhere here, and psi value should be plus 153 degree. That means somewhere here. That means this is your collagen. Okay, this is your collagen. So this is your allowed region. Okay, so this is your allowed region. The phi and psi value should be placed for anti-parallel beta sheet like here, over here. That should be for anti-parallel beta sheet. The phi and psi value will converge over here. For parallel beta sheet, the phi and psi value will be placed somewhere here. And here for collagen, there should be phi and psi value will be converged over here. So this for we can say as a whole, this is your allowed region. This is your allowed region. Okay, so in this way, we can also we can draw the value of your left-handed and right-handed alpha helix. Let's see right-hand alpha helix. As we know that the phi value for right-hand alpha helix should be your minus 57 degree. That means phi value minus 57 somewhere here actually, and your minus 57 somewhere here actually, and your psi value should be minus 47. minus 47 means actually your psi value should be your minus 47 psi. This is your psi, and this is your psi, and this is your psi. Minus 47, that means somewhere here. Minus 47, that means somewhere here. Okay, this is your alpha helix. This is the range for your alpha helix. This is your range for your alpha helix. So this is your range for your allowed region of your for your right hand alpha helix. That means for right hand alpha helix, we know phi value should be your minus 57 degree. This is minus 57 phi, and for your psi value should be your minus 47 degree. This is phi, this is minus. Okay, minus 47 degree. That means somewhere minus 47 means somewhere here. That means this is the region for your this is the region for your alpha helix, left-handed alpha helix, right? So let's see where exactly your right-handed this is for your right hand. I have committed this is your right-handed alpha helix. Let's see where exactly will your left-handed alpha helix be placed, right? So we know for left hand alpha helix, a particular amino acid chain or a particular polypeptide chain should have the values like phi values like your plus 57 degree, and psi values like your plus 47 degree, right? So let's see, phi value is your plus 47 means somewhere here, and psi value should be your plus phi value should be your plus 57, and psi value should be your plus 47. Okay, this is, that means somewhere here. This is your left-handed alpha helix. Left-handed alpha. This is the region for your left-handed alpha helix. This way I have drawn how exactly you can draw. The different the values of different phi and psi values for different types of secondary structure like your alpha helix, beta helix, like this. So we drew that, we came to know that we exactly drew your parallel the values for the parallel beta sheet is taking a place here, and anti-parallel beta sheet is actually taking the place it is actually placed in the first block or somewhere here, and your collagen is placed here, and your right hand alpha helix is placed here, and your left hand
is how we can draw Ramachandran plot by ourselves. And this is what Ramachandran plot is all about. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and if you have enjoyed this video, make sure that you have subscribed to my channel, and definitely like my videos and share with your friends. Thank you.